Our colorful ride for the day around Karachi. And here is our adventurous guide.
My name is Atif Bin Arif, and I am the co-founder of Super Safari Express Private Limited. And we started this venture in order to educate the locals and to show them the true colors of our city.
Assalamu alaikum. If I can just have your attention for 2 minutes, please.
Given a choice, the women of Karachi decided to sit on top of the bus rather than inside, which is quite an unusual sight for this city. Now, the tour caters mostly to locals, but there is also a handful of foreigners joining us today. So although this is not quite war zone tourism, it does feel a little bit like it in this very violent city. The organizers are not taking any chances and will be accompanied by armed guards at all times.
Karachi residents rarely explore their own city, certainly not by bus or on foot.
In recent years, because of the situation in the city, I think as a mother, I've become more protective. And I think this was like one of those opportunities of doing something in the safe environment.
For security reasons, the itinerary changes for every trip and is never shared in advance.
When I first came in, I look at the guards with all the rifles around. To be honest, it's a little scary because I come from Singapore. I'm really glad that I made the decision to come.
This is Karachi as you've never seen it, helping locals and tourists discover the hidden gems of this sometimes very noisy city. And the itinerary is also very interesting. There are old colonial buildings, markets, but also churches and Hindu temples. In a country that is predominantly Sunni Muslim, where minorities are often shunned and persecuted, that choice of itinerary is quite the statement.
Our idea is to educate the local citizen and to show them the harmony that really does coexist.
Peace and harmony in Karachi, who would have thought? Hopefully, Atif's optimism will last. For now at least, the tour is booked solid every weekend. Kim Ghattas, BBC News, Karachi.